Hello everyone, once again welcome you all in the online lectures. And in last lecture we are talking about a heteroatom and heterocyclic compounds. So in this lecture we will be discuss some heterocyclic compounds and their retrosynthetic analysis. So here I am giving one target molecule which containing a heteroatom and a heterocyclic compound. So this is the compound. And this compound containing a heterocyclic ring, we know that. So this molecule containing a, that is CN bond. So this is a amide function group, and therefore we can break this amide function group. So what it use? It use from one side, that is a amine, that is methyl amine, and from other side it can use a carbonyl group which having a good leaving group, right? So in the back synthesis we can take this lone pair of nitrogen and it will attack on this carbon group and it will be used formation of amides, right? Now so this molecule again containing a CN bond, that means we can break this bond and here we can take a electron withdrawing group so that it can be easily removed. So this is a electron removing group, and if the amine will be attack on this carbon, so this bromine will be goes off, and then remaining function group will be same like this, that is COOAT, along with it use formation of a, that is methyl amine. So this is a methyl amine. Then secondly, we have to prepare this molecule. So this molecule can be prepared by function group interconversion. That means, so this bromine can be converted into a OH, so that it can be easily prepared, and the remaining will be same, that is COOAT. Now this is alcohol. So this alcohol can be prepared by simply as an epoxide. That means if you take this epoxide along with that, it containing a COOAT negative charge here, and it can be prepared by a activating group, that is a COOAT. And here is a COOAT, right? So this is a function group. So here we can use this group for the attack on this epoxide. Let us take synthesis. In the synthesis, we can take this ester. So this ester, COOAT, COOAT, it will be treat a base, that is a sodium ethoxide, in presence of ethanol, as well as a epoxide. So what it use? It use formation of a CH2CH2CH2OH, that is alcohol, and then remaining will be same, that is COOAT. Now we have to remove this one of the ester group by simply hydrolysis, that is H3O plus. It will be hydrolyze this ester group, and secondly we have to heat, that can be used at decarboxylation. And secondly, again we have to prepare the ester of this group, that is by using sodium ethoxide in presence of ethanol. So what it gives? It gives a formation of a such type of compound, right? Now again we can treat this compound with red phosphorus plus bromine, that will be used PBr3, and it will be attack on this alcohol and gives formation of a alkyl halide, that is Br, and then remaining group will be same, that is COOAT. Now we can treat this compound with, that is methyl amine, NH2ME. Then what it gives? So it will be gives formation of a target molecule. So how it form target molecule? That means initially this amine will be attack either on this group or either on this group. Suppose it will be attack on this group. So what it gives? It gives formation of a, that is N methyl ester, in this way, right? And in second step, it undergoes cyclization, and it gives formation of a original target molecule. So in this way, we can prepare a good synthetic route for the synthesis of such type of heterocyclic compound. So we can say that in the last step, there is no chance for double N alkylation, because here there is no chance for the double N alkylation, because the intermediate amino ester form gets cyclized, right? So this ester, that is we can say that, so this ester will be undergoes a cyclization, or we can say that the lone pair of nitrogen will be involved in the conjugation of this yester, and therefore there is no chance for the second N alkylation, because here suppose this methyl amine will be attack on this group, then it undergoes a cyclization, that means rapid cyclization, and therefore there is no chance for the double N alkylation at this position. That means the intermolecular reactions are more faster compared to the intermolecular reaction, and therefore the cyclic amines, we don't have to take any special precautions. So here it can be easily formed, such type of target molecules. Let us take one more example on this heterocyclic compound. That means if it containing a hetero atom and heterocyclic compound. So here is a such type of heterocyclic compound is there. So it containing a cyclic amide, right? So this is target molecule. We can break, we know that this molecule containing a amide function group, and therefore we can break this CN bond and this CN bond, right? So that means two CN bond we can break here. So what it gives? So here is pH, it gives a phenyl amine, that is we can call as a aniline. Along with, it gives formation of the remaining function group will be same. So here is pH, here is COOAT, and here we want to take a leaving group, and again that is OAT. Again here we want to take a good leaving group, that is ATO. That means we can say that ester, right? Again we can say that it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dicarbonyl compound, or we can see it is again 1,5 dicarbonyl compound, and therefore we can break this 1,5 dicarbonyl compound. So we can break either the C3-C4 bond. That means we can break this C3-C4 bond. So what it gives? From one side it gives formation of a ATO C double bond O CH2 C double bond O OAT, plus it gives this, so this group, that is pH CH2, then CH2, and here is COOAT, and we have to take a double bond at this position, because it will be a 1,5 dicarbon system, and therefore it gives 1,4 attack, right? Now so this molecule is called as a ethyl cinnamate, and we know that this ethyl cinnamate is again available. That means we can say that from the cinnamic acid we can prepare this ethyl cinnamate, right? So synthesis, in the synthesis we can take this ester COOAT. We can treat this molecule with base, that is sodium ethoxide, in presence of ethanol and this ethyl cinnamate COOAT. So what it gives? It gives formation of a molecule that is like this COOAT. So here is again COOAT, and here is COOAT. So we can treat this molecule with pH NH2, that is aniline, and it gives formation of a target molecule. So this is the simple method to prepare such type of target molecules using a ester as well as amine. So here is one more example on the heterocyclic compound. So it is amine. We know that so this molecule containing a CN bond, and therefore we can break this CN bond. How we can break this CN bond? From one side we can take a double bond, and from other side we can take this amine. So this is a amine, that is NH2, and here we can take this double bond. So this amine will be attack on this carbon, it gives a cyclic 6 member ring, and then it gives formation of this molecule, right? Then in second step, we know that this is alpha beta unsaturated system, and therefore we can break this alpha beta unsaturated system. So what it gives? So it gives formation of, from one side it gives a carbonyl group, and from other side it gives a ketone, so that it gives a cyclization, and therefore so what else remains? So this carbon, so this containing a amine group from one side, that is NH2, and from other side this CH2 CH3, then again from this side it gives a formation of a aldehyde, and then remaining will be as a, so this 1, 2, 3, here is carbonyl, and then it containing a methyl group, right? So this methyl will be in presence of base, you can take this proton and it will be attack on this carbon-carbon. It use beta hydroxy compound, and second step, it eliminates the water molecule, right? Now here, so what else remains? If we see here, it is 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it is 1,5-dicarbonyl compound. So this 1,5-dicarbonyl compound, we can break the C2-C3 bond. That means this C2-C3 bond. If we break this C2-C3 bond, what it gives? From one side, it gives a carbon-carbon double bond in this way, right? Plus from other side, what else remains? So this CH2-CH3 will be same. So it is again containing a aldehyde group, that is same. And then remaining will be the CH2-CH2-CH2-NH2. So this amine will be remains here. Now, you know that if you want to prepare such type of amines, so we can convert these amines as a function group interconversion as an amide, or we can say nitrile, right? Suppose we convert these amine as a nitrile. So what it use? So it use CN here. That means this CN, then CH2, then CH, then here is aldehyde CHO, and here is CH2-CH3, right? So this molecule will be remaining here. Now, so it containing a aldehydic function group, and therefore we can break. Sorry, here is one carbon, 1, 2, 3 carbons are there. There 1, 2, and 3 carbons are there, and therefore it also containing a 3 carbon, that is CN, 1, 2, and this carbon. Now we can break the bond at this position, and what it use? It use formation of a, that is double bond CN, plus along with it use formation of a aldehyde, that means CHO, CH2, CH2, CH3. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, that is butanaldehyde. Suppose if you take the base, it will be abstract the proton from this side, it will be attack on this bond, and it gives formation of this molecule. So this is the one of the method. If we convert as a function group interconversion as a amide, instead of taking this nitrile, if you convert this amide, so what it gives? It gives formation of CH2, C double bond O, CH2, CH2, CH. How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then here is a aldehyde CHO, and here is CH2-CH3. So this is one of the method. Now if you see, if you convert this into ester, that means amide can be easily prepared from the ester, that is by function group interconversion, and therefore we can take this as a ester, that is ETO, C double bond O, CH2-CH2, and then here is aldehyde CHO, and then CH2-CH3. Now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 1,5-dicarbonyl compound, and we know that if there is such type of 1,5-dicarbonyl compound, we can break this C3-C4 bond. And if we break this C3-C4 bond, what it use? It use formation of a one side, that is double bond, plus along with it use formation of a aldehyde from other side, that is butanaldehyde. 1, 2, 3, 4, that is butanaldehyde, right? So this is another route. That means there is two methods we can easily prepare such type of target molecules. Let us see synthesis here. Synthesis. In the synthesis, we can prepare such type of molecule by easily taking as a this aldehyde, that is butanaldehyde. 1, 2, 3, 4 butanaldehyde. If you treat this molecule with the base, that is R2NH in presence of acid, right? And in second step, if we treat this molecule with this alpha beta unsaturated ester, and thirdly, we have to hydrolyze this molecule, then what it gives? It gives formation of a, that is such type of ester, that is ETO, then here is CH2, CH2, then here is CHO and CH2, CH3. And in second step, we have to treat this molecule with a, again, base, that is R2NH, that is base in presence of H plus, and secondly we have to treat this molecule with again this alpha beta unsaturated ketone, and then thirdly we have to hydrolyze this molecule H3O plus. So what it gives? It gives formation of that is ATO, C double bond O, CH2. Then here is a remaining molecule will be same, that is here is CHO is same, and then here is CH2, and then C double bond O, CH3, that is ketone, right? So this molecule is formed here. Now we have to treat this molecule with base. So this base will be undergo cyclization, and if undergo cyclization, it gives formation of a cyclic system which containing a alpha beta unsaturated system. Here is methyl group will be same, and then CH2, then C double bond O, OET, right? Now we have to treat this ester with amide, and if we treat this with amine, then there are two carbon group, that is this ester group and this ketone group, both undergoes a, we can say, base addition reaction, and therefore we have to protect the one of the function group. That means if we protect this ketone with diol, and then we can treat this with a ammonium hydroxide. So what it gives? It gives formation of a protected ketone here, that is a diol. So this is diol, and then these amide will be converted it into a ester, will be converted into amide. Here is one CH2CH3, so there is one molecule CH2CH3. Now we have to reduce in presence of LAH, then the amide will be converted into amine. How it will be converted into amine? Here is protected ketone will be same here, then alpha beta unsaturated system here, so this is the same, then CH2, and then here is NH2. Now we have to deprotect this ketone, and how will we deprotect this ketone? That means by simply taking with a hydrolysis, that is in acid, and then so it will be deprotonate, as well as it undergoes cyclization, and if undergoes cyclization, it gives formation of a target molecule. So original target molecule we can prepare so in this way, right? So in this way we can prepare such type of heterocyclic compound, and then we can make the desired target molecule by using a suitable synthetic equivalence. So friends, with this we can stop here. The remaining molecule will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you.